Hi, this is Dr. Graves from the CSUN Geography Department and geographyplanet.org. This video tutorial is designed to help students learn to join two data sets that have a common identifier together. In this case, it's the Census Tract ID here and census data downloaded from the US Census and data from the California EPA that has census tract column and some data on environmental conditions in each of the census tracts in the state. This is a part two of a two-part series basically showing you how to do the same, to arrive at the same conclusions or the same outcome, but using two different techniques. The first one was using the VLOOKUP tool, and this one is going to use the pivot table tool. So I'm going to go back through how to prepare the data for this join procedure. First thing we're going to do is click here in cell B1, where the word California County appears, and then I'm going to click on the sort and filter tool and select filter from the options, and then from the drop down menu in cell B1, unselect select all and select only Los Angeles. So that gives us only the census tracts from Los Angeles. I'm going to copy this data that was Control Shift down to highlight, or Control A will work, and I'm going to move it to a new sheet. Click on the plus button to indicate new sheet and press Control V or paste to paste the data. All right, so that is half the data. The other half is we're going to grab this census tract data here. And I'm not going to get all of it because it will bleed off the screen, and we don't really want that. So I'm just going to copy these first few columns of data, and I'm going to paste them onto our new sheet, but I'm going to leave a column or two blank. Okay, so we have our first steps complete, and now the second step involves constructing or reconfiguring the census tract identifiers. These are appearing as numbers. If you will see down here on the ribbon at the bottom, that it is calculating min, max, average, which indicates that this data is functioning as numbers, not text identifiers, and we need to fix that. When it's functioning as text, if you highlight the data, you will see there's only a count down on this ribbon at the bottom of your screen. These values here should match up, but they have too much extraneous data. Everything before the S in this column of data has to be removed. And so I'm going to show you quickly how to do that. First, we're going to do the EPA data. And I'm going to put tract ID here at the top. And since this column of data that says Los Angeles is useless to us, we're just going to use that. So in order to convert the census tract number into a census tract ID that is functioning like text, as it should, I want you to type in an equal sign, follow that by the word concat, C-O-N-C-A-T, and then an open parentheses, which is a command that will essentially paste together two elements in your spreadsheet. And so what I want is to enter a zero, because the leading zero has been removed from the data in column A, and we're going to add it back. So 0 between quotation marks, and then you can just type in A2, which will highlight the cell value in A2. Close that with a closed parentheses and press enter. And now you have a leading 0 on the tract ID, and that is nearly correct. So we want to copy that to the rest of the column of data, covering up all of the cells that have the word Los Angeles in them. And then once that formula is copied to the rest of the column and it's highlighted, and if somehow you unhighlighted it, go ahead and highlight it again. Press Control C to copy. And then what you want to do is paste values in over top, or to replace your formulas with just the values. Once you do that, you'll get this little error message telling you the number in this cell is formatted as text, and that's exactly what you want. So that's correct. We need to do that once again to this column of data. So I'm going to replace the values in this column P, and I'm going to call it tract ID 2 because it will match. So what I'm going to do with this column O is to highlight it, click on Data tab, go to Text to Columns, and then select either delimited or fixed width. But since we did delimited in the last one, we'll do delimited in this one. I'm going to click Next, and I'm going to put in check the other button, uncheck the tab, and our delimiter is going to be the letter S. So everything to the right of the letter S in column O is going to remain, and we'll use that as our tract ID. I'll click Next once again. This we can leave however we want, or even select Do Not Import because we don't really need it. This column is what we do want to keep, and it's going to appear in column P, but we want to tell it to treat it as text. So select Text, and then you can select Finish. And it's going to give us an error because there's data in column P already. And do we want to replace that? Yes, we do. Now we have tract ID and tract ID, and they should match. The next part of this gets a little bit tricky, so try to pay close attention. I'm going to click on the O above column O, go back to the Home tab, and just delete that column altogether. So we have a set of data here. I'm going to copy this block of data by highlighting it. It was Control Shift right arrow and down. I'm going to press Control C. And what I'm going to do is to move it over to column B. I'm going to move my cursor to column B. I'm going to press Control and down arrow, which sends me to the bottom of that data. And I'm going to press Control V. So what I am doing is moving the tract ID over so that there is only one column that contains all of the tract IDs. The next thing I'm going to do is highlight these cells of data and going to delete them because I don't need them anymore. I am next going to move this block of data up one, and you can either highlight it and Control X to move it up one like that, or you can just delete the blank row. The next thing I need to do is to move this data here, which is the census data, over to this spot right here. so that this data forms four new columns. Here, I'll highlight that in pink so you can see where that's going to go. So now I'm going to control X, which is to remove and replace, or to move, paste it over there. Okay, so now I need to get rid of some of this extraneous data, including this block of data that I copied, but I'm going to leave the column headers. So that's deleted now. And I'm going to copy this set of column headers. I'm not going to copy, I'm going to control X. I'm going to control and move over to here. Now, these column headers represent the data that is here. And at this point, if you want to, it really doesn't make a heck of a lot of difference, but you might want to put some X's in here to indicate that there is no data, no numeric data in this, that sort of block of data. There's multiple ways that you can arrange that, and you may want to put X's here as well to indicate that there is no data. That is an extraneous step, and you don't necessarily need it. So what we do have now is a block of data from B to P, column P, and all the way down, and I've highlighted it, and that we will use the pivot table then to arrange it into a single block of data. So highlight your block of data, click Insert, click Pivot Table, which is perhaps the most brilliant and useful tool in Excel. Click OK, and a new sheet will appear. Now it's called Sheet 2. What we want to do is to take Tract ID, grab it, and pull it down to the rows box. You can drag it again to the values box, and it will tell us now that we have two instances of that tract, which is exactly what we want. And then if we want now to add the data that concerns us, we can just pull it down from this box into the values box. So perhaps we want to see what is the number of people per census tract that have asthma. So you pull that down, and at first it counts it. So you say, well, I don't want just the number of cells that have data on asthma. Give me the value, change the value field settings, and make that a sum, an average, a max, a min. It's all going to be the same because there's only one cell that actually has a number in it. So you click OK, and there the sum of asthma, could be the max or the min, is 43.1. And so that's from the EPA data. What if we want to know how many people are Hispanic or Latino in there? We drag that down and change the value field settings once again to sum, and there is 1,324. And if you want to check on that, we can go back to the EPA data, go to the top, and here's the asthma figure, 43.1, and the census data for the same tract. I think we got Hispanic, Latina, 1324. So that is a very useful set of tools that you've been shown. I would suggest you practice it, and you can find the raw data set for this at geographyplanet.org, or if you're a student of mine, it'll be in the classroom folder.